Good evening. My name is Dr. Akash Shakta, and I'll be presenting the results of a study evaluating the role of MIS OLIF in degenerative lumbar deformity correction. To begin with, a bit of introduction. Degenerative changes in the lumbar spine set in after the middle age, and while the old age can lead to a complex set of deformities. These deformities cause, in turn, a loss of sagittal and coronal alignment, leading to mechanical compromise. Now, this mechanical compromise leads to the entire symptomatology of the patient, the most common of which is pain. The role that sagittal and coronal alignment of the spine have to play has been recognized in the past decade, and a number of procedures have been described to tackle this issue. For example, interbody fusions and even osteotomies. In this study, we investigated the role that minimally invasive oblique lumbar intervertebral interbody fusion has to play in this context. The study was a prospective observational study conducted over a span of 24 months, starting in April 2018 at Dr. B.M. Central Railway Hospital, which is a tertiary care spine center in Mumbai. We used functional, radiological, and clinical criteria at preoperative and at postoperative day 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, and 1 year. The functional criteria that we used were the visual analog scale for both back pain and leg pain, and the Oswestry Disability Index. We used four radiological criteria, namely scoliosis, lumbar lordosis, the mismatch between pelvic incidence and lumbar lordosis, and the sagittal vertical angle. In all, we enrolled 39 patients over this 24-month duration, with a mean follow-up of approximately 16 months. The average age of a patient was 65.5 years, with a mean of 1.6 levels operated in each patient. The mean blood loss was less than 70 ml, and the approximate duration each patient stayed in the hospital was 1 week. We could achieve fusion in 38 of the 39 cases at the end of 12 months. We encountered 6 complications, 2 of which were Angry-Sua syndrome and 2 case subsidence. One was a superficial infection and 1 venous injury of the segmental vein. Of note, we did not witness any neurological deterioration in any of our patients. This is an example of a single level OLIF at the L3, L4 level. As can be seen, the scoliosis has corrected from 23.8 to 2.5 degrees, and the mismatch between pelvic incidence and lumbar lordosis has corrected by approximately 14 degrees. This is an example of a 65-year-old lady who underwent a 3-level OLIF, and as can be seen, the Cobb's angle has corrected by approximately 28 degrees, and the pelvic incidence and lumbar lordosis mismatch has been corrected by around 30 degrees. This is a summary of all the radiological outcomes in our study. The scoliosis corrected by an average of 15 degrees, lumbar lordosis by around 19 degrees, the PILL mismatch by 24.3 degrees, and the SVA corrected by a mean of 73.5 millimeters. All of these were statistically significant with a p-value of less than 0.001. In terms of functional outcomes, both the VAS scores for back pain and leg pain were significantly improved at post-op day 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, and 1 year as compared to the pre-op VAS scores. Similarly, the Oswestry Disability Index significantly improved at 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, and 1 year as compared to the pre-operative scores. We searched for the literature with regard to this study, and we could find a lot of papers, the most pertinent of which was the one was a meta-analysis published by Zhu et al. In the Global Spine Journal this year. They included 16 studies enrolling a total of 519 patients and noted that OLIF resulted in significant improvements in the spinopelvic parameters and functional outcomes. A similar study published in the Indian Journal of Orthopedics in 2019 by Patel et al. Enrolled 15 patients and noted similar improvements. However, not all were very approving of OLIF. The study published by Kim et al. In the Asian Spine Journal 2019 noted that OLIF alone is not a very effective tool to address the deformity. However, they noted that the extent of correction can be predicted by a full extension lateral view with radiographs in the lumbar spine. So, to conclude, according to our study, MIS OLIF is a very effective tool to counter the issue of degenerative lumbar spine deformity. If done well, it can result in a decent correction in the spinopelvic parameters and a good functional outcome. However, one word of caution will be to watch out for the complex anatomy that can be seen in certain patients and the possible complications that can arise therein. Thank you.